So, if you guys are joining us, this segment will be sponsored by Microsoft Azure, and we're going to be learning about PlayFab for the next little bit. Today, we're going to be going over some of the details that we can add to make our save and load, sign up, and login systems a little bit cleaner, and some tools that will likely be useful if you're going to be using PlayFab in your Unity game. First of all, let's do a little demo of where we are with the game right now. So our game is called Pocket People. You have little creatures, little humanoid, which they have their own little personalities. They can go on adventures. You can give them items that they can interact with. Right now we have the very bare basics in so far, and we're slowly going to be working towards all of those different features. And we're using PlayFab to make this game better in a lot of ways, and it's helping us to do some cool things. For example, we're able to log in, sign up, create an account, and log in with that account. And that's useful because it means that we can play the same game on different devices or even different computers. And some of the other features PlayFab can help us with are saving and loading, as we just mentioned with logging in, but also it stores that information for us. But there are other features like analytics that are useful. There are features like in-app purchases that are useful. We can do A/B testing. We can do leaderboards. There's a lot of cool features that we're going to use to make this game so much more than it would be without these features. So we're going to look at how to do that today. We've already got our sign-up form here. We can switch over to put in our information if we have an account. If we sign up, we enter a username, let's say something like this. Oh, that's our username. Our email might be something like this. We have to use alana@lana. And now once we log in, we see this dice. What does the dice do? Oh, what do you know? It changes the color of our creature. Not very visually pleasing yet, but this is a very rough, almost like a wireframe of what the game will be. We're just getting started with some of the user experience and making the game smooth and understandable. Once we've done that, we have our home for our characters. And we start with this will be our character's profile picture. The idea would be that you can add items to the scene. It can interact with that item. Maybe it's a type of food, and if that character likes that type of food, it will eat it. If it doesn't like the type of food, it will look at it, maybe shake its head, and go do something else. So it will have a little bit of a sense of a personality. We can leader pocket people to water, but we can't make them drink. We can also leader pocket people to go explore outside their home. And it will encounter enemies, which it will battle, and its health will be removed when it gets attacked. When it defeats an enemy, we receive some money, and that's what we use to buy the different food, equipment, weapons. Characters have little items that they can use and interact with. We can also go look at our other characters here at home while that one's adventuring, and it will continue to go where we left off. It loads in from the beginning, but it does continue on. So it's one of these type of games where you sort of interact a little bit, leave it to do some things. Then when you return, there's new gameplay that's available, like buying new items or upgrading or whatever things you want to do. First session, we looked at how to sign up and log in, how to set that up. And then we did how to save and load information. So the first thing we're going to look at is how we're doing the combat here. So to give you an idea of how this works, if we leave the game, we come back in and we sign in, lana@lana.lux, we can see our character still out adventuring even though we left the game. How we did that? Let's take a look at our code. We want to look at our save controls. So let's open PlayFab save. Using system. This is a namespace we need for Unity to use date time. We set it to the current time that they go on the adventure. And we're saving the key, which we are setting to the date time as a string. And then in PlayFab client API, PlayFab client API update user data, it will update it. Let me show you what that looks like in PlayFab when we're logged into the website. We can see that the character that I just clicked on does not yet have the adventuring, or it was deleted. But if we logged in and went, we would see the date time here. Here it is, fighting the enemies. And so when we return, we can compare to this. And we do that, we use get player data at the beginning of the scene, then new get user data request, keys is null. So we can debug it and say save current. Now, loading it in. So we check if, as long as the data is not null and the data contains the body color, then we can now set the color of the character here. Now, another thing that we're doing here when we load the info, but basically what it's checking is if it has this key, we need to set our character to be currently on an adventure so that when we log in, we know it's out adventuring. It's not home where it is usually. And we plug this into set adventuring. And over here in our set adventuring, We take the character number, because there might be more than one. That's the one that we're going to show with a sword over it here. So if we have more than one, we can check this against all of them. We get that number and then the date time string. I think this is very likely to be useful if you're using a game that has a login feature. So now that we have this as a date time, first we get the time span difference. We want to know how long the character's been adventuring for, so that if our adventure is 1 minute, we know that they're done and we can put them back home again. They've completed the adventure, they're back home. Now, there was something in here that I wanted to point out as well. When we start, we check if the key is null or not, if it contains the key. If we're done adventuring, we can remove that key and then not need to calculate anything. We want to remove one of these keys. We can log in and we can actually delete adventure time here. And you can say save player data. So we can, in fact, from PlayFab, we can log in and delete keys, but we can also do it with code. There are two more things I want to cover. They are both with the login. Last time we opened the game, right there, we automatically logged in even though we started on the login screen. The simplest way to save our data with Unity, and we're using that with PlayFab to do an auto login. I added a method called load if available. And to do that, we take that string, we use playerprefs.setString, and then we can just hit playerprefs.save, so we don't have to log in every time. We can just go immediately right into gameplay, which is one thing that we have not done yet, but we will be adding to this game is a way to log out in case we want to have a different account or sign up with a new account or anything like that. And all we would have to do is delete our player preferences. So we'll add a button in our main screen, and we'll put a little button here that's a logout button, and that will delete our player preferences so it does no longer stores that information. And the last thing that we're going to cover, the error codes from before were showing up like this. If you're logging in, you see this, it's not the best user experience. You can get the idea that invalid input parameters, but we can clean that up to be much more friendly. This is what we had before, but what we can do here, we can now do a switch where we get the error.error, and then we can write in whatever we want to let the user know what's happening. So let's type in username like that. Okay, so here's one of the things that we caught, one of the error codes that we have here in our switch. And then as our default, if we missed anything, we can now get the full error report. And that's how we handle validation. So that covers all of the more detailed elements of signing up, logging in, saving, and loading with PlayFab. I hope that was helpful for you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in for this. I know I'm excited for Pocket People to reach its full vision.